My two horses are recovering after being mauled by two pit bulls in their own backyard.
The attack happened yesterday on the 900 block of Weicker Road in Severn. A school bus full of children were watching. 11 News reporter Reba Hollingsworth is live in the newsroom. She has more on what the horses' owners had to say. Reba?
Well, Rod, when this attack happened, a school bus was parked right across the street, about 30 kids on board. One of the students called the homeowner. The other student recorded part of the attack.
This cell phone camera captures the moments before two pit bulls attack two ponies in Severn. You can see one of the horses trying to get away. The owner got a call at home that the dogs were mauling her two ponies, Flash and Kohler.
One of the dogs had him by the face, and Kohler was actually whipping this dog in the air, and the dog wasn't letting go.
In the middle of chaos, Rosie McNeil stepped in to fight the pit bulls off of her horses.
I was able to open the gate and get him out and shut it before the other dog came out. And I grabbed one dog by the back of the neck and put him or her in the pen also.
Kohler suffered a leg injury, and both horses have gashes on the outside of their mouths. The worst of their injuries are on the inside.
As long as they don't get any infections, they should be okay. I have to wash their wounds constantly. Anytime they eat anything, I have to wash it because it's all on their mouths.
The McNeils say the pit bulls came from a nearby trailer home and got into their backyard. The blood from the attack is still on their fence. The owners of the pit bulls wouldn't go on camera, but they say the dogs managed to get out of their fenced backyard. The owners also say their pets aren't vicious and they never attacked before. The two pit bulls are now with animal control, and the owners say they want to try and get their dogs back, but the McNeils are worried.
I don't want these animals anywhere near this neighborhood. We have children that ride up and down these streets. If that had been a child, there's no telling what it wouldn't have been. It would have been ugly. It wouldn't have been nice.
Now, one of the pit bull owners did pay half of the vet bill. Now, the owners will most likely have to pay fees and a fine in order to get their dogs back. Reporting live from the newsroom, Reba Hollingsworth, WBAL-TV 11 News.